I picked up a rope when I was, shoot, I was probably, I bet I was 11, 12 when I tried it. And, well, actually, one time they had a junior rodeo in Illinois, and I remember this. And I'd never roped before in my life. And I got on, I think, my dad's horse. I was maybe 8, 9. And I was gonna try to rope the calf out of the box. I'd never done it before.
Right.
Well, it was a team roping horse. And I just remember that I ran out there and I got close, and all of a sudden the horse ducked off and I freaking, boom, face planted. So it was not a good experience. But then when I got to Oklahoma, I picked it up and kind of played with it, but I didn't have a roping horse. And, I tried a little bit, probably when I was 11, 12. And then when I didn't do it a whole lot because I just, didn't have an arena, didn't have cows, didn't have anything. And I thought that I was going to get to enter. And my mom, she told me all summer, she's like, well, if you practice and rope that dummy, we'll try to get you going. Well, when it come time to enter, I hadn't practiced enough for her. Of course, I'm 13-year-old kid and, thinking that you're practicing a lot. And just was kind of by myself and not really around that environment. So she said, no, you're not going to enter. You didn't practice enough. And so then I got really mad about that. And so then I started practicing and really getting with it. And I turned a barrel horse that was just kind of crazy and ended up being an outstanding little breakaway horse. So when I first initially started going, I guess my freshman year, I was 14, I think. And I started roping, but she wouldn't let me high school rodeo yet. I wasn't allowed to rodeo until I got a little bit better. So my sophomore year, she let me start going and to like the high school rodeos and more the things and roping. So that's really when I started getting into it, was my sophomore year. So.